Good morning, Colfax, and welcome to the fifth CTV show of the season.
Today, Gabe Piet has prepared a special segment to help students transition into the realities of adulthood.
And John and Sarah will keep you up to speed on the PBL.
Welcome to the show.
Senior portraits are due by November 30th, so make sure to get those taken and turned in to Kendall Williams.
Speaking of pictures, all sports and clubs need to send in their photos to Kendall Williams so the yearbook team can make sure to include you in this year's book.
Reality is, one day we will all be on our own, and the ability to cook will be an essential skill. Gabe Piet took it upon himself to start getting ready for life after high school.
Thanks, Gabe, for that delicious recipe. I know I'll be taking that to college.
Last week, our entertainment team and Jake Smothers captured all the magic of homecoming week in a 15-minute highlight video, and it is now available on the CTV YouTube channel for your viewing enjoyment.
On Thursday, October 18th, Lean Crew will be putting on the most spooktacular haunted house in Colfax history. Held in the metal shop, this year's haunted house will provide an array of frights and scares to be enjoyed by all ages. Even better, it won't break the blood bank, as it is only $3 for one ticket and $5 for two. Don't be a scaredy cat and make sure to swing on by if you dare.
That sounds like a spooktacular deal. Our Colfax athletes have the PBL spooked with so many quality performances in this past week. And John and Sarah will have the action. It's time for Around the PBL.
Hey there, Colfax, and welcome to Around the PBL.
PBL football, volleyball, girls golf, and cross country teams are just over halfway through the season, and the championship races are heating up.
Every game, meet, and match this time of year could be the difference between winning a championship and or making the playoffs. This was on full display when Bear River came to Colfax this past Monday.
Hey, The much-anticipated battle for the top of the PBL volleyball standings between Colfax and Bear River on Monday had fans fired up, but it was all Falcons as the girls dismantled their rival across the river 3-0. The offense was hitting on all cylinders, with Hallie Newman, Grace Bliss, and JC Dean hammering home kill after kill. The first meeting between these teams was a 3-2 dogfight, but in this meeting, the Colfax defense was able to neutralize college-bound hitter Callie Bickmore by putting up a nearly impenetrable blocking wall and getting stellar floor play by Haley Mulick and Sarah Detweiler. Just over halfway through volleyball league play, Colfax enjoys a 2-game lead in the title chase, but will have to maintain their intensity to close out the league and grab a top 4 spot in the section playoffs.
Great energy in the pavilion and a great win for our volleyball program. Colfax had an awesome homecoming week, shout out to our leadership program, and along with all the fun events and celebration, the race for the PVL football championship raged on around the region. Sarah was on hand for the Colfax game at Marston Stadium.
Colfax celebrated homecoming last week and our football guests were the Marysville Indians. The Colfax offense got off to a slow start, but the defense got the scoring started when Jake Green took a first quarter pick 55 yards to the house for the first 6 points of the night. The defense generated 4 turnovers on the night, giving the offense a few more opportunities, and they took full advantage, scoring on 2 touchdown drives by the end of the first half. The Falcons never looked back from their 21-0 halftime lead and cruised to a 44-0 final. Across the river last Friday, Bear River was beating up on Colfax's next opponent, Lyndhurst, hammering the Blazers 49-0 to maintain their undefeated status.
The Bruins continue their stellar play, but will have to face Foothill and Lake of the Pines tonight. The Mustangs are coming off an impressive 24-14 win over an injury-plagued center team and look to get into the title chase with the win over the Bruins.
I don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but I think the Bruin defense is going to take the life out of Foothill, and when the dust settles on Friday, we will be looking at the biggest football game of the year when the Sac B's number 12 ranked team, Bear River, comes to Colfax to take on the Sac B's number 14 ranked Falcons in the River Bowl on October 19th.
That's a bold prediction, Sarah. But with 2 of the 5 football games in the PVL in the books and Colfax and Bear River at the top of the PVL, it's a prediction I think all the football fans look forward to seeing come true.
And I have to add that despite the recent defeat, Center is still a legit spoiler and ranked 15th amongst all schools. And when they get healthy, it will take the best of the PVL to knock them off.
No doubt about that, Sarah. The best of the PVL is also on display at the Ridge Golf Course on Tuesday, where Colfax celebrated senior night and punched their ticket to the CIF playoffs. Jordan Rooker, Amber Holt, and Roxy Reynolds finished 1, 2, and 3 respectively against Marysville and locked down second place in the PVL.
And the excitement on the course did not stop there. Varsity golfer and freshman Lauren Conway scored a hole-in-1 on the third hole during that match. That is huge because get this, the odds of a touring professional getting a hole-in-1 is 2,500-1, and for the average golfer, 12,500-1.
Unbelievable. Congratulations to Lauren, and thanks for the actuaries at hole 3 for those stats.
The cross-country team took their heads-up, wings-out mentality into the second all-PVL meet on Wednesday and staked the Falcon flag on the top of the PVL hill. Sierra Hagen smashed the field with a first-place finish, and it was Emma Sanders' gutsy performance breaking up Bear River's Fab Four that brought home the team victory for the girls.
In the boys' division, Center had a stranglehold on the PVL, and the Colfax boys had to have a big day to shake up the league, and that's just what they did. Billy Groth continued his quest for a PVL title with a second-place finish, and hard-charging senior Connor Ruman ran strong to take the third slot. Griffin Labuddy and newly minted varsity runner freshman Toby Howard each pushed the field and helped deliver Colfax a first-place finish.
The cross-country team will run their last invitational on Saturday before the PVL Championships on October 24th, where the girls will battle with Bear River for a title and the boys with Center also for a title. Special thanks to Noah Francella, who won the boys' JV division and then doubled back to capture pictures for us here at CTV. Thank you, Noah.
A great time of year for all fall sports. Good luck to all of our teams next week, and we'll see all of you guys at the River Bowl next Friday. I'm John McCann.
And I'm Sarah Detweiler, and we'll see you next week, Colfax.
Our CTV sports team was very busy this past week, so it was reporter Mary O'Rourke who headed to the gridiron to bring us this student-athlete profile.
6'2", 180 pounds, two-way football star, Jake Green racks up stats on offense and defense like a player in a video game. But who is Jake Green?
athletic. He's tough, both mentally and physically. Presence brings confidence to the players around him.
Jake Green is burning up the football field with 652 receiving yards and 8 touchdowns in the first 7 games of the season. And he strikes fear in opposing quarterbacks as he patrols the secondary looking to pick off any ball thrown his way. Jake has a simple approach to his success.
I think people should just be honest and do what they say they're going to do and be hardworking.
By all accounts, Jake lives by his simple philosophy.
He's a leader. He's a positive leader on this campus. I think people look to him for how he models what to do and how to do things. He's always doing the right things, and his presentation is incredible. He's nice to people. He's just a great overall young man.
On the field and off the field, what you see is what you get with Jake Green, a nice person that works hard and no doubt will make an appearance in this end zone next Friday for the annual River Bowl. I'm Mary O'Rourke reporting for CTV.
Thank you, Mary. Indeed, what you see is what you get. Great piece.
The River Bowl is a week away, but the hype surrounding this game has already started. As a huge thank you to the best students and staff in all of Northern California, leadership and your admin team have teamed up to offer a $5 themed shirt and a special pregame end zone barbecue. That's right, a commemorative shirt and a pregame meal for less than a fancy cup of coffee. This package will be available while supplies last next week.
Winter Sports Night is next Tuesday at 6 p.m. If you're planning on participating in any winter sports, this is a must event. Alpine Skiing has a new coach and he is eager to meet you. Here's a little sneak peek at what the Alpine team is all about. Run away with me. Lost souls in reverie. Running wild and running free. Alpine skiing, Nordic skiing, men's and women's basketball, and wrestling. They will all be there. Well, that's all we have for this week. Make sure to tune in next Friday when Mary O'Rourke gets us ready for an interactive Mental Health Awareness Week that will include a fair and perhaps a few dogs.
Until next week, Colfax, I'm Daviana Ackerman.
And I'm Atania Mira, signing off.